The United States Navy currently operates 11 aircraft carriers capable of operating fixed-wing aircraft. These carriers serve as the backbone of U.S. naval power, providing global force projection, air superiority, and rapid response capabilities in strategic regions worldwide. Let us name all of them. Number 1. The USS Nimitz CVN-68. This is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier of the United States Navy and the lead ship of the Nimitz class. Commissioned on May 3, 1975, she is the oldest active carrier service in the U.S. Navy and the longest-serving aircraft carrier in the world. In January 2015, Nimitz changed her home port from Everett, Washington, to Naval Base Kitsap in Bremerton. Throughout her long service history, Nimitz has been involved in several major military operations. In 1991, she played a crucial role in Operation Desert Storm, launching airstrikes against Iraqi forces. More recently, in 2020, she was deployed to the Indo-Pacific, operating in the South China Sea as part of U.S. efforts to maintain regional stability. Number 2. The USS Dwight D. Eisenhower CVN-69. This is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier of the United States Navy and the second ship of the Nimitz class. Commissioned in 1977, she is the first U.S. Navy ship named after President Dwight D. Eisenhower. Since entering service, she has participated in major deployments, including the Gulf War in the 1990s, and later U.S. military operations in Iraq, Afghanistan, and Yemen. Over the years, she has played a key role in maintaining U.S. naval presence worldwide. She remains an integral part of the Navy's operational fleet, serving as the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 2. Number 3. The USS Carl Vinson CVN-70. She is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier of the United States Navy and the third ship of the Nimitz class. Commissioned on March 13, 1982, she has participated in several major military operations, including Operation Desert Strike, Operation Iraqi Freedom, Operation Southern Watch, and Operation Enduring Freedom. Over the years, she has played a crucial role in U.S. naval operations worldwide. In 2011, the body of Osama bin Laden was buried at sea from her deck following the U.S. Special Forces raid in Pakistan. Carl Vinson continues to serve as a vital asset in U.S. power projection and remains actively deployed in various regions. At number 4, the USS Theodore Roosevelt CVN-71. This is the fourth Nimitz-class nuclear-powered aircraft carrier in the United States Navy. Commissioned on October 25, 1986, she saw her first combat action during the Gulf War in 1991, launching airstrikes against Iraqi forces. Over the years, she has been involved in numerous military operations supporting U.S. interests worldwide. Known as the Big Stick, she has played a crucial role in global security, conducting joint exercises and deterrence missions. As of August 2024, she is actively deployed with Carrier Air Wing 11 and serves as the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 9. Theodore Roosevelt continues to operate in strategic regions, projecting U.S. naval power across the globe. Number 5. The USS Abraham Lincoln CVN-72. This is the fifth Nimitz-class aircraft carrier in the United States Navy, commissioned on November 11, 1989. She played a key role in Operation Desert Storm in 1991, launching airstrikes against Iraqi forces. In 2003, she supported Operation Iraqi Freedom, contributing to extensive combat operations. Following the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami, she led humanitarian relief efforts in Indonesia. In 2019, she became the first Nimitz-class carrier to deploy with F-35C Lightning II fighter jets. Over the years, she has conducted multiple deployments in Pacific, Middle East, and Indo-Pacific regions. At number 6, the USS George Washington CVN-73. She is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier of the United States Navy and the sixth Nimitz-class carrier. Commissioned on July 4, 1992, she is the fourth U.S. Navy ship named after George Washington. In 2008, she became the first nuclear-powered aircraft carrier to be forward deployed at Naval Base Yokosuka, Japan, enhancing U.S. presence in the Indo-Pacific. Over the years, she has participated in multiple joint exercises and security operations in the region. She played a vital role in humanitarian relief efforts after the 2011 Tohoku earthquake and tsunami in Japan. George Washington remains a crucial asset for U.S. naval power projections worldwide. Number 7. The USS John C. Stennis, CVN-74. She is the 7th Nimitz-class nuclear-powered aircraft carrier in the United States Navy, named after Senator John C. Stennis of Mississippi. Commissioned on December 9, 1995, she has played a vital role in combat operations and power projection worldwide. She participated in Operation Enduring Freedom and Operation Iraqi Freedom, launching airstrikes in support of U.S. forces in the Middle East. Over the years, she has conducted multiple deployments to the Pacific, Indian Ocean, and Persian Gulf, reinforcing U.S. naval presence. In 2019, she was deployed as part of Carrier Strike Group 3, operating in the Indo-Pacific and Middle East. Number 8. The USS Harry S. Truman, CVN-75. She is the 8th Nimitz-class aircraft carrier of the United States Navy, named after the 33rd U.S. President Harry S. Truman. Commissioned in 1998, she is homeported at Naval Station Norfolk, Virginia, serving as a key component of the U.S. carrier fleet. Since June 2014, she has been the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 8, leading numerous deployments. In 2016, she conducted an 8-month air operation against ISIL for the East Mediterranean as part of Operation Inherent Resolve. Over the years, she has participated in extensive combat operations, deterrence patrols, and joint exercises worldwide. Number 9. The USS Ronald Reagan, CVN-76. This is a nuclear-powered Nimitz-class supercarrier in service with the United States Navy, named in honor of Ronald Reagan, the 40th U.S. President. Commissioned in 2003, she is the 9th ship of her class and a key asset in U.S. naval operations. In 2015, she replaced USS George Washington CVN-73 as the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 5, the only forward-deployed carrier strike group. She is homeported at Naval Base Kitsap. Over the years, she has participated in joint exercises, humanitarian missions, and deterrence operations. Number 10. The USS George H.W. Bush, CVN-77. She is the 10th and final Nimitz-class supercarrier of the United States Navy, named after the 41st U.S. President George H.W. Bush. Commissioned on January 10, 2009, she is homeported at Naval Station Norfolk, Virginia, and serves as a key force in U.S. naval operations worldwide. She has participated in combat missions in the Middle East, including Operation Inherent Resolve, conducting airstrikes against ISIS. In 2017, she led Carrier Strike Group 2 in operations in the Mediterranean and Persian Gulf. More recently, she deployed in 2022 and 23 to the European and Middle Eastern theaters, reinforcing U.S. presence amid global tensions. At number 11, the USS Gerald R. Ford, CVN-78. This is a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier of the United States Navy and the lead ship of the Gerald R. Ford class. Named after U.S. President Gerald Ford, she honors his World War II service aboard USS Monterey in the Pacific. Commissioned on July 22, 2017, she features advanced technologies, including the electromagnetic aircraft launch system and improved radar capabilities. After extensive testing and trials, she completed her first operational deployment in 2022, supporting NATO exercises in the Atlantic and Mediterranean. In 2023 to 2024, she deployed as the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 12, reinforcing U.S. presence in Europe and the Middle East. As the most advanced carrier in service, Gerald R. Ford continues to lead in global power projection and maritime security. Number 12. Although not yet in active service, the USS John F. Kennedy CVN-79 is expected to enter service very soon, making it worth mentioning. She is the second ship of the Gerald R. Ford class and is named after the 35th U.S. President John F. Kennedy. She was launched on 29th October 2019 and christened on 7th December 2019. Once commissioned, she will enhance U.S. naval capabilities, serving as key asset in power projection and global security. As she nears active duty, John F. Kennedy will soon join the fleet, carrying on the legacy of her namesake in modern naval warfare. With this, the buzz is signing off for today. But we'll see you guys again in our next video. Bye-bye.